students, welcome to Justin NCRT Solutions. In this video, we are going to see 7th Standard Math Chapter 4, Exercise 4.4, first question. Set up equations and solve them to find the unknown numbers in the following cases. Part A, add 4 to 8 times a number, you get 60. The given statement, we are going to form an equation. After that, we are going to solve that sum. First one, we are going to take that, let a number B, X. We have taken that number as a X, unknown number we have taken as X. Now the condition is add 4 to 8 times a number. 8 times a number, 8 into X. 8 times means 8 into X. 8X plus 4 is equal to 60. 8 times a number, when we are adding 4, it is giving 60. Now we are going to solve this sum. 8x plus 4 equal to 60. We are going to take this plus 4 into right hand side. So 8x equal to 60 plus is going right hand side. So minus 4. 8x equal to 60 minus 4 equal to 56. Now 8 into x is there. When x is, 8 is going right hand side, it will become division. 56 divided by 8. So x is equal to 188, 7 8s are 56, x equal to 7. So the value of x equal to 7. Now we are going to solve part B. This is equation, this is solution for the question. Now 1 fifth of a number minus 4 gives 3, 1 fifth of a number. So we are going to take, now we are going to take let a number B. We will take this number as Y. Now 1 fifth of a number. So we can write it 1 by 5 into Y minus 4 gives 3. Now 1 fifth of a number, we can write it as Y by 5. This minus 4 is going right hand side. So 3, this is minus 4 is going plus, it will become plus. So 3 plus 4. Now Y by 5 equal to 3 plus 4 equal to 7. Now we are going to take this 5 into right hand side. Now Y equal to 7 into 5. Because this is in multiplication, when multiplication is coming right hand side, it will become, sorry, this is division. When division is coming to right hand side, it will become multiplication. Now Y is equal to 7 5s are 35. So Y value is equal to 35, and the equation is Y by 5 minus 4 equal to 3. Then part C is, if I take 3 fourths of a number and add 3 to it, I get 21. We are going to take a number, let a number B, Z. We are going to take this number as a Z. Now 3 fourths of a number, so we can write it 3 by 4, 3 Z divided by 4, 3 fourths of a number, and add 3 to it is giving 21. 3 Z divided by 4 plus 3 is equal to 21. Now this is required equation. From this equation we are going to find answer. Now 3 Z divided by 4 is equal to, plus 3 is going right hand side, so it will become subtract, minus 3. Now 3z divided by 4 is equal to, 21 minus 3 is equal to 18. Now 3z is equal to 18. When division is going right hand side, it will become multiplication. Now z is equal to 18 into 4, multiplication, so it will become division, divide by 3. 1 3 is 3, 6 3s are 18. So now z is equal to 6 into 4, z value is equal to 6 4s are 24. We got z is equal to 24. Now we are going to solve part D. When I subtracted 11 from twice a number, we are going to take a number. Part D, let a number. Let a number be L. We have taken let a number L. Now, according to the condition, twice a number minus 11 is equal to 15. This is our required equation. 2L minus 11 is equal to 15. Now we are going to solve. 2L equal to 15 is there, minus 11. We are going to take the minus into right hand side. So 15 plus 11. 2L equal to 15 plus 11. Both are the same sign. So we are adding 26. L equal to 26. 2 into L is there. So we are going to divide it by 2. When it is, when multiplication is going right hand side, it will become division. So now 1, 2 is 2. 13 2s are 26. So L equal to 13. And now part E. Munna subtracts thrice the number of notebooks. We are going to take let number of notebooks is, we are going to take that M. Number of notebooks is equal to M, and the statement is thrice the number of notebooks he subtracted 50. 50 from 50 they are subtracting thrice a number of notebooks. M is equal to, and it's giving 8 is answer. 50 minus 3M equal to 8. Now minus, we can interchange the places. We can interchange the places. Now 3m is equal to 8. 50 is going right hand side, so minus 50. Plus is coming to us a minus. Now minus 3m equal to 8 minus 50. Signs are different. We have to find the difference. Difference is 42. And greatest number is 50. In front of 50, minus sign is there. So minus 42. Now both side also minus having. Minus, minus gets cancelled. Now M is equal to 42 divided by, this 3 is coming right hand side, so division. 42 divided by 3. Here 1, 3 is 3. And remaining 1 is there. So now 12. In 12, we have 4 3s are 12. So M is equal to 14. So the value of M equal to 14. Now we are going to solve part F. And here the question is, when all thinks of a number, we will take a number. Let a number is, we will take it as N. When all thinks of a number, see if C adds 19 to it, divides the sum by 5. We are going to add N plus 19, and with the sum we are going to divide it by 5, and it gives, C will get 8 equal to 8. So the required equation is this is. Now we are going to find answer. We are going to solve that, and here the equation is 50 minus 3m equal to 8. And here this division is going right hand side, so it will become multiplication. N plus 19 is equal to 8 into 5. 8 5s are, N plus 19 is equal to 8 5s are 40. Now N is equal to 40. This plus is going right hand side, so it will become minus. So 19. N equal to 40 minus 19 is equal to 21. So the value of N equal to 21. Now last sum, part G. Here G is, unwhere thinks of a number,
Anwar thinks of a number if he takes away 3 from 5 by 2 of the number. The result is 23. So now we are going to take, let a number, O. We will take it O. Let a number O or we will take it as P. Let a number P. We are going to write that equation. If he takes away 7 from 5 by 2 of a number, so 5p divided by 2 minus 7 is giving 23 is answer. Now the required equation is 5p divided by 2 minus 7 is equal to 23. Now we are going to take 5p divided by 2 is equal to 27. This minus is going right hand side, so plus 7. 27 plus 3 is equal to 5p is equal to 30, and we are going to take this 2 into right hand side, so multiplication 2. Now p is equal to 3 2s are 6, 60 divided by this 5 is going right hand side, we are dividing by 5. Now p is equal to, in 60, 1 5 is 5, in 6, 1 5 is the remaining 1, 2. So 12 5s are 60. So the value of P is equal to 12. Okay, that's all students. Kindly give your suggestions in the comments box. Share this video to your friends and subscribe our channel. Thank you.